Well, good evening, church family. I want to welcome you tonight to our Good Friday service. I want to let you know that this service tonight is going to be youth-led. Not only youth-led, but youth-scripted, crafted. Every part of this, they put in themselves. They have come up with this entire service for you tonight. This is the story of the crucifixion of Jesus. And for it to be led by youth, to me, is incredible. And it's just such an honor to be part of so many talented kids sharing their gifts to tell Christ's story. So I'm going to pray first real quick, and then we'll start with Lexi here in scripture. Bow your heads for me. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, so much for your sacrifice on this day, for this Good Friday. Lord, you made it good. Father, thank you for everyone that's come here tonight, and thank you for these youth as they share their hearts to tell us part of your story. Just help us to stay focused on you as we consider this day. In your name we pray. Amen.
There they crucified him, and with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. And Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do, and cast lots to divide his garments. And the people stood by, watching, but the rulers scoffed at him, saying, He saved others, for him save himself. It is he, the Christ of God, his chosen one.
Father, I beg you, take this cup from me. Nevertheless, let it be your will and not mine. Father, I beg you, if I cannot go through these events without drinking from this cup, then let it be so. Come, the hour is at hand. When the Son of Man is betrayed by the hands of sinners.
Listen to the story. fishers of men, he said, Simon was my name, but he called me Peter, the rock. At supper, he washed my feet. I wanted him to wash my whole body so that I could be cleansed of the sins I had committed. Dependable is what they call me, yet I denied Jesus 3 times the day he was taken.
There is a way of redemption. We don't innocent man putting to an end the wrongdoing of all humanity. How can one describe such a day? Good Friday.
Makes us so alive.
our pains, carry our disfigurements, all the things wrong with us. We thought he brought it on himself, that God was punishing him for his own failures, but it was our sins that did that to him, that ripped and tore and crushed him, our sins. He took the punishment, and that made us whole. Through his bruises, we get healed.
It's that sinking feeling you get when you realize that you thought you had everything figured out and then you had no idea what you were doing. Which is incredible that at the moment when they realized we had no idea what we were doing, Jesus had already said on the cross, "Father, forgive them, they don't know what they're doing." That's what all of this moment was. It's the moment where Jesus said, "Every sin of this world, past, present, future, man, woman, child, will be laid on me and nailed to that cross and taken." So he took all that sin, and the moment he died, there were so many people who he was sent to hell. And once he got there, that's where all that sin was cast. The wages of sin is death, and separation from God leads to death. So when he was down in that pit, I have to imagine that as he got there, that the devil could feel that coming, that he knew, oh, here comes the sin of the world. This is the biggest thing that's ever come in here. I am going to torment this soul harder than any soul I've tormented in my whole life. This is going to be incredible. When he got to that gate and there stood Jesus, this is the part where the devil went, no. Because he just realized what had happened. This is the moment where Jesus said, every sin of the world has been laid on me, and I have taken it, and I will now cast it here. And now everyone knows that I am the way, the truth, and the life, that no one comes to the Father except through the Son. And that all those who earnestly repent of their sin will be redeemed, will be forgiven. And this stops right here. And that was where he left it. At that point, we moved to the tomb. And that was Good Friday. That was the day that Jesus took everything. Anything that we have, this is the time that we get to cast it off, that we get to lay it at this cross. That earnest repentance. Not that, oh, I'll just ask for forgiveness for that later. No, the things that are really dragging you down, the things that are crushing your soul. This was the day that Jesus said, bring it here, and I will take it. So everything that we did from welcoming him to the city and praising him to the moment where we decided and held crucify him, we get that chance of redemption. And I really think that's why that sky turned dark. That was the moment where everyone realized what they had done. And even a Roman soldier said, surely this was the Son of God. That's when he realized what they had done and repented. That's the earnest repentance. So as hard as Good Friday is, it's part of the story, and it's the middle. See, Sunday's coming. The victory happened here. But the resurrection of joy is on its way. We just have to wait. It says he laid in the tomb for 3 days and then got up. He predicted that. He told the disciples that that's what was going to happen. Yet they didn't believe him. They scattered. Even after seeing Ezekiel do it with the dry bones. Even after Lazarus being raised. Even after a sick girl that they said, Jesus, you have to save her. And he got there and she was dead. And he said, oh no, she's just sick. This moment, when this happened, is when the disciples scattered. And that's Good Friday. It's the day we realize that this is our second chance. This is the moment we learn what redemption looks like. Nicole's going to pray for us, and I'm going to dismiss us tonight. And just remember, as hard as this part of the story is, Sunday is on its way.
Let's bow our heads. Hey God, I just want to pray for all the problems in the world. I want to pray for every person in this room, and I hope that somehow they were touched by what we said tonight. And I hope that somehow they choose to run with this message and tell the whole world that you love us so much, and that you'd do anything for us to make sure that our safety and our freedom is the best. And we don't know how much you love us. We can't fathom how much you love us. And it's awesome. It's amazing. And I hope that we all realize that you do love us a lot. And in your name,